Hi, I'm John Ball, Forest Health Specialist, and together with Kurt Allen, entomologist with the U.S. Forest Service, for today's forest, we're going to talk to you about mountain pine beetle. The mountain pine beetle is about the size of a head of a pencil or the tip of a match. And this little beetle can kill a tree, not alone, but by attacking the tree in hundreds, getting beneath the bark, laying the eggs, and having its larvae essentially girdle out the tree. The beetle has to work its way through the thick bark of the tree to successfully attack it. But the tree's not defenseless. It'll produce this pitch, these white globs, to try to keep the beetle from entering it. Most of the time, the beetle's successful, and you'll find hit trees covered with these pitch masses, usually beginning of August till about the middle of September, as these beetles have successfully worked their way into the tree. After spending the fall, winter, and early spring inside the tree, the beetles eventually mature, and starting usually about the end of July, start emerging and create these exit holes in the tree. When they leave a tree, remember that tree is now dead. They will not attack it again, but will now go out to find live trees to begin the cycle again.
The adults attack a green pine tree and get in and create the long parent galleries that go vertically up and down the tree. They lay eggs off of those sides of those galleries, and in the fall of the year, the larvae hatch and begin feeding. The larvae will spend their entire life under the bark of the tree. The following spring and summer, they'll finish maturing, and the new adults will come out the following summer.
Trees that are attacked this late summer, early fall, will still appear green even until next year. But next year, about the same time the beetles fly, they're going to turn red. And then after that, the following year, they're standing dead trees and are gray. And quite often on hillsides, you'll see the green infested trees, the red trees nearby, and then in the center of those, the gray trees, the ones that have been dead for several years. If you have an infested tree, one of the best ways of dealing with it, of course, is to have it felled, hauled to a mill, and processed into lumber. But if for some reason you're not able to do that, you have too few trees that are inaccessible, now what do you do with the infested trees? One of the things you can do is to cut the trunk into 2-foot lengths sometime between mid-September and the 1st of March. What'll happen is that piece will dry out and it will kill the beetles as they mature. And if after March 1st, say the middle of May, you can take that piece and just roll it once so that the underside is now on top, you'll have even heating and you can end up killing anywhere between 80 to 100% of the beetles in that piece.
One of the other ways that you can treat your beetle-infested logs is to burn them once they're down. And as you can see here, we don't need to turn them into ashes, just heat them up good to kill the beetles underneath.